Hello, this is Dr. Keith Miller, and I will be discussing the formation and classification of folds. But first, why do rocks sometimes fault or fracture in response to deforming forces, and in other cases, form folds? To understand how rocks deform, we need to understand two terms, stress and strain. Stress is simply an applied force. Stress is described by the magnitude of the force, that is, how strong is the force, by pressing it little or pressing it a lot, okay? And the direction, that is the force compressional, is it tensional, is it shearing? Strain, on the other hand, is how the material responds or changes shape in response to an applied stress. There are three types of strain: elastic, plastic, and brittle. In elastic strain, the material will change shape when a force is applied and return to its original shape when that force is removed. So, for example, this deformation is reversible. An example is of such an elastic material is a rubber band. When I apply a stress, the rubber band changes shape. But when I remove that stress, it returns back to its original shape again. So I apply the stress, changes shape, remove the stress, and it returns back to its original shape. In brittle deformation, when a stress is applied, the material will break or fracture. Although initially elastic, this piece of wood will fracture if I rapidly apply a strong force. Elastic materials, including rocks, will change their behavior and become brittle under the right conditions. And yes, rocks do behave elastically. When the force being applied increases, an elastic material will eventually reach its elastic limit. Energy will continue to be stored in elastic deformation until its elastic limit is reached. At that point, it will behave like a brittle material and break or fracture. This can be illustrated again by our rubber band. So, if I again apply a stress to the rubber band, it will change its shape. Remove the stress, it turns back to its original shape again. However, if I keep applying a stress, eventually I'll reach a point at which it reaches its elastic limit. Ow! Okay. And when the rubber band breaks, it releases all of that stored energy. And this is what happens in an earthquake. Rocks begin deforming elastically, and when they reach their elastic limit, they fracture. And the result is a fault. Lastly, in plastic deformation, the material will change its shape when a force is applied, but that change of shape is permanent. Examples of plastic materials are silly putty or the steel rod. So I apply a force, and they change their shape. But when I stop applying the force, these materials remain deformed. Do the same with silly putty. Apply a force, changes shape, I stop the force, and the deformation is permanent. When rocks deform plastically, they create folds. Rocks are more likely to behave plastically when they are hot. As a result, folds typically occur in rocks deeply buried below the surface where temperatures are high. Rocks can deform plastically in a variety of ways. Several terms are needed to describe and classify different types of folds. We can use this stack of colored paper to illustrate a stacked series of sedimentary rock layers. I can fold this stack of paper into a fold. Okay? And in this case, each half of the fold, it's called a limb, dips away from the crest of the fold. This type of fold is called an anticline. If I fold the paper in the opposite way, the two sides or limbs of the fold now dip toward the crest of the fold. This type of a fold is called a syncline. Now, if I draw a line down the crest of the fold, So I now have a line drawn down the crest of the fold. That line is called the fold axis. If I tilt the fold so that the fold axis points downward, we call that fold a plunging fold. If the fold axis is horizontal, the fold is non-plunging. So we can have plunging or non-plunging anticlines, or plunging or non-plunging synclines. Now further imagine that we draw a plane down the center of the fold such that it defines a mirror image on each side of the fold. This plane will include the fold axis and is called the axial plane. If the axial plane is vertical, such as shown here, the fold is called symmetrical. However, if the axial plane is tilted, the fold is asymmetrical or inclined. Folds can be both plunging and inclined. So this is a horizontal inclined fold. This is a plunging inclined fold. Also, a single fold doesn't occur by itself, but is part of a series of folds. Thus, anticlines and synclines alternate in a deformed area of rocks. And this is what you would find in a folded mountain range, such as the Appalachian Mountains. You will learn later how to identify these types of folds in a geologic map, but that is for a later module.